The earthquake crisis in Haiti is now a cost crisis in Central Florida. Governor Charlie Crist is under immense pressure to find ways to pay for health care costs for Haitian evacuees. West 2's Danielle Bellini has late breaking information from the newsroom. And Danny, you spoke to a local congressman today.
I did, Aixa. Congressman Alan Grayson, a Democrat representing the state, weighed in on how much of the aftermath of the earthquake crisis in Haiti the state can financially bear. Today, we also just heard from the governor, who once again is talking about Florida's responsibility.
We always want to be as good as Floridians always are and do everything we can to help our neighbors, particularly in a time of need. So we actually have stepped up the repatriations of our friends from Haiti. Florida has never slowed down. We never will. We're always going to help them. We just would like a little help with the financial end of things.
They're survivors, focused on touching down on U.S. soil. And today, once again, Central Florida welcomed evacuees from Haiti. While this plane landed in Sanford, in the nation's capital, the focus is on how to pay for the medical costs of earthquake survivors being treated here in our state. But Florida Congressman Alan Grayson doesn't think the state is as burdened as it may seem.
And there's only 526 Haitians that have been admitted to hospital since the tragedy occurred. There is no possible way that anybody could rationally conclude that our hospitals have been overloaded by this.
Governor Charlie Crist asked for federal assistance and help from neighboring states to cover the responsibility Florida bears for being so close to Haiti. The move suspended flights out of Haiti carrying people who need serious medical help. While Grayson thinks it makes sense for the governor to ask for funding for people in need,
what does not make sense is to cut them off. It doesn't make sense to say that our hospitals are closed to people who will literally live if they can come and die if they can't.
Today at a stop in Miami, the governor clarified that his intention is not to stop medevac, but said we need the U.S. government to tell us who's going to pay. Grayson says that's fine, but wants to be clear our hospitals should still be open and ready.
These are only people who are on the cusp of death. The people who are being brought here now are, in some cases, people who were dug out yesterday.
I asked the congressman about a timeline. How long should the state care for evacuees who need urgent medical care? He told me, as long as we're needed. Live in the newsroom, Danielle Bellini, West 2 News.